Hello, everybody. This is Ultimate Life Form RB, and welcome to another episode of Sonic Adventure 2 Battles Story Mode Playthrough. Last time, we started the final portion of the hero story with Eternal Engine and Meteor Herd. And now, in this episode, it is time to finish off the hero story with the final two stages and the final two boss battles. Get comfortable, folks, because this episode is a long one. And we're going to start things off with Stage 15, Crazy Gadget. A Sonic level. And this is considered by many to be among the hardest levels in the game. Some people even go as far as to say the hardest level. I won't quite go that far, but this is not an easy level. And, the main gimmick of this stage, as you can see here, are these little things called gravity switches. What these things do is, well, they switch the gravity. So, and we're going to be using them a lot on this stage. So, get used to seeing them, because there's at least 10 different parts we'll be using them to get through the stage. This stage is a rough one. It really is, and I don't really know what to say. It's just a bad stage. It's a long stage, and if you don't know what you're doing, if you're going through it for the first time ever, be prepared to take a long time, because you're going to have to really familiarize yourself with this stage. And if you want to get a good rank, it's probably going to take a few practice runs. And I thought I could get that ring container, but I guess because of the gravity, I couldn't. And I will state right now, this run through Crazy Gadget is a very, very sloppy run. I'm not happy about it at all. And in fact, I was so disappointed with it that after recording everything for this episode, I actually went back and redid this stage and got an A ring, and I actually recorded that too. In fact, after this episode is uploaded, I will actually upload video of me getting an A rank on Crazy Gadget, because I knew I could do so much better than what I recorded here. But nonetheless, yeah, you got the beetle enemies with electric shields. Gotta watch out for them. And also, this level is crawling with artificial chaos enemies, including this variety, which releases little individual units called chaos cells. I believe that's what they're called. They like to explode. Explosions are bad, especially for Sonic, because they hurt. And you can actually get killed pretty quickly by those things if you're not careful. We got robots with shields. You can only attack them when they pull their shields back to try and shoot you. That's your opening to attack. And look at this little trap. Beetles with electric shields. And then once you get through them, you gotta do a light dash. I mean, you got these little warp tube things too, which are like, there's three of these, four actually, linking the sections of the stage together. You're going to be using those quite a bit. And, yeah, this was just a really sloppy run through the level. And more artificial chaos. Watch what happens here. I think the reason I got hit there is that I did a homing attack just as the thing, I guess just as I was about to hit it, it launched its lasers and shot me. Like, perfect timing. And right here is where we can find another Sonic upgrade, right about here, and it is the Flame Ring, which will upgrade Sonic's somersault ability and allow him to break iron containers. Let's go. Okay, now that we got that, it's time to move on. And here's a major problem with the gravity switches. You'll press B to try and activate them, and Sonic will, like, randomly do a somersault. I think that's just due to the somewhat glitchy nature of this game. Like, this game has a lot of glitches. It really does. They really could have tried to polish it up a little bit, especially when they made the transition from Dreamcast to GameCube. I mean, this, when they made Sonic Adventure 2 Battle, it was basically a straight port, glitches and all. They really didn't, I don't think they even tried to update the graphics or anything to take advantage of the GameCube's power. And spin dash failure right there. I spun just as that crate came down. And you got a light dash here. That's the only way to get through that section. I mean, this level throws a lot of stuff at you. This is not an easy level. It really isn't. Especially the final room just before the goal ring. The final room just before the goal ring is horrible. It's like really nasty. And right there is the golden beetle. I miss it completely and blow my chance at getting it, so no golden beetle for me. But we're actually approaching that final room I was talking about within a minute or so. And you're not going to believe it if you haven't seen it before. Get over the spike ball trap. But like I said, I did record an A-rank run of this that I'm going to upload after this episode of the Story Mode playthrough is done. Gravity switch, more robots. We gotta kill these guys to open the door so that we can continue. And right down this hallway is the Room of Doom. And I tried to do a jump to stop my momentum, and I did it right into the laser wall. And here it is. The Room of Doom. That's what I call it anyway, and as you can see right here, I sped up the footage because I took way too long to get through here, mostly because there's one section where you have to do a homing attack to an enemy in order to reach a platform, and I had totally forgotten about it until I saw the enemy, like, at the top of my screen. Right here, you can see me just randomly wandering around. Right there, I see the enemy and home attack to the blue platform. And this room, I can imagine many players going through this room for the first time and probably definitely dying more than once trying to get through here, especially first time ever trying to learn everything. But once you get everything down and you practice, you can really get a good score on here. But this level, though, is just ridiculous, especially this room. I don't even understand the true purpose of it. Did they just throw this in just to make it challenging or something? But then again, this is a Sonic game. Sonic isn't much known for logic. But anyway, there it is, the goal ring. And despite taking almost 9 minutes, Crazy Gadget is done.
Just made it.
And I got a C rank. I don't think I even deserved that. I deserved a E rank, quite frankly. But anyway, we got ourselves another emblem, and it's time to move on with the story.
Let's take care of business first, shall we, Sonic? Hand over the Chaos Emerald, slowly, and then we'll talk about your girlfriend. That is, if you really cared for her.
Handing over the fake emerald? I can kill two birds with one stone!
Put the emerald down right there and back off!
time, villain doctor.
Ha! Whoa. Sucker.
You thought you could trick me with that fake emerald, didn't you?
So, how did you know it wasn't the real one?
Tails!
Because you just told me, Fox Boy. Now, for a little space ride. The capsule clears the colony. Bad!
I'm counting on you, Tails. Amy, take care of yourself.
Farewell, Sonic the Hedgehog.
Sonic! It has the same wavelength and properties, but is less powerful than the real one.
The same wavelength and properties. Can I do this?
Farewell. Now we have some unfinished business to take care of. If you give me the real emerald, I will release you both. You have my promise.
Sonic!
Huh?
Sonic asked me for the first time to do something for him. I won't let him down. I won't give up!
Uh-oh. Tails is pissed. Okay, here we go. Final battle against Dr. Eggman. This is the last boss in the game for Tails. And as you can see, there are no rings. It's just you, Eggman, and your health bar. No rings to help you out here. Now, the first two shots to Eggman are pretty simple. But after you do two shots, he'll start using special attacks. He'll do a missile barrage like here, or he'll do a giant power laser. Like right here. But when doing that, he's vulnerable from behind, so that's your opening to hit him, and there you go. Pretty easy once you get his patterns down and you know how to dodge the attacks, but if you just keep moving, you'll be fine.
I feel some strange energy.
Wow, he made it.
Hey, Sonic. Whoa, I wasn't sure if I could pull that one off. Somehow I managed to use the Chaos Control.
Chaos Control? Are you okay?
I'm worried about Tails and Amy. I hate to ask, but could you help them? This is our last chance. I got it. Before the cannon fires, I'll slam dunk it in there!
Alright, this is it. Final rush. Hurry and find the point of the cannon. This is the final hero story stage. And as you can see immediately, the main gimmick behind this level... this level is basically specifically designed to showcase Sonic's grinding ability. In fact, anytime you're not standing on a solid platform or flying through the air, you're grinding on a rail. That is like how you get around in this level. And depending on your opinion of grinding, this stage is either heaven or hell. That's all I'm gonna say. And due to the glitchy nature of this game, it can sometimes be a little aggravating. Especially on this level. This level especially could have used some polish. And as you can see, the level's basically nothing but a giant bottomless pit with the earth below. So if you happen to fall, Sonic is going to get a one-way trip through the Earth's atmosphere. And who wants that? scary moment right there. I thought I was going to die, but I managed to land on the rail. So yeah, if you grind on certain rails, you can jump off to do tricks for points. And like I said, with this level can either be a lot of fun or it can be a lot of trouble. And basically, just be careful. Don't get too crazy here, because if you're not careful, you will die here. And I believe somewhere in this area, the golden beetle can be found, but I always miss it. Someone correct me if I'm wrong, but I think the golden beetle is somewhere in that area. He may be later in the stage. I don't know, because I've never actually gotten it. And, use the bounce attack to break open these boxes so you can keep going. And, another scary moment right here. I don't know if this was a glitch or what, but for some reason he didn't hit the vertical rail and I almost died. And this section here is basically nothing but vertical rails. It's basically nowhere to go, literally nowhere to go but up. To use the old saying, but this is taking it literally. Like I said, this is the final level of Hero Story. After this comes the final boss of Hero Story, and then that's the end of Hero Story. And it'll be time to finally start the Dark Side Story, which I'm really looking forward to, so I can finally move ahead with this project. I mean, and it's probably not going to take that long, really, this project. I mean, this is only episode 7, and we're already at the end of the Hero Story. But I think, like, a lot of that has to do with the, since I don't have a time limit restriction anymore, I can make the videos as long as I want. If this were still the old 15-minute, or especially the 10-minute time limit, this episode would probably be like episode 20 or something. But enough about that. And it's actually here in this level where we can get another Sonic upgrade. And it's actually an upgrade that Sonic shares with all the other characters in this game. And got on this rail with practically no momentum, so it was like a snail at first, like, come on, Sonic, go, go, go. Can you please grind faster? But, and now here's the part where you can get the upgrade. You take the orange rail, because the purple rail is part of the normal path, and you launch off of it, holding the control stick forward so you can reach this platform, and take this here rocket. And after you jump through a few platforms and then hit a vertical rail, and you'll find the upgrade right about here. The Mystic Melody. The Mystic Melody is an upgrade that every character gets, and basically when you play the Mystic Melody, special events, if you will be triggered in a level, and you play the Mystic Melody at these little shrine things, and as I demonstrate here, play the Mystic Melody, and in this case a trail of rings will appear to let you do a light dash. Unfortunately, I do a bounce attack instead and almost commit suicide. Couldn't do the light dash because I had a magnetic shield, so no light dash for me. And it's actually not that much farther to go in this stage. And like I was with Crazy Gadget, I get a better score here than Crazy Gadget. I get a B rank, but like Crazy Gadget, I was not satisfied with this run. I took too long, quite frankly, but that was because I had to get the Mystic Melody. So I actually uploaded an A rank run of that level as well. Well, I recorded it. I'm going to upload it after this is finished, just like the Crazy Gadget A-Rank run. And here's the final part of the level, running down the side of the Space Colony Arc with debris chasing after us. And there you go, Gold Ring.
Yes!
Final Rush is done. All the levels of the Hero Mode are finished. Hero Story, excuse me.
Too easy.
There's the B rank. I was hoping for an A, but looking at that time, how much time I took, I probably shouldn't have expected it. But there's another emblem, and now it's time for the final boss of Hero Story, and I have a feeling you guys might just know who it is.
You never cease to surprise me, Blue Hedgehog. I thought that capsule you were in exploded in space.
You know, what can I say? I die hard. You actually saved me, you know.
It was a Chaos Emerald, wasn't it? But there's no way you could have activated the Chaos Control using an emerald that's fake. So, there's more to you than just looking like me. What are you, anyway? But you know, I can't let you live. Your adventuring days are coming to an end.
All right, this is it. The final battle against Shadow.
Before this is over, I'll show you the true power of Chaos Control!
Now, even though the two of you are running down a long walkway, this is not a race. This is a fight. And, actually, the environment you fight in is a lot more dangerous than Shadow is. Because you have to keep moving. If you're too slow, the sections of the walkway will start to fall off. And you'll go with them if you don't move it. And, as you can see, I've already got Shadow into the red because there are multiple ways to actually hit him. But after you've hit him a few times, he starts doing special attacks. Like this, the Chaos Spear. But as long as you keep moving and you jump at the right time, you can dodge it. And plus, he starts making sure you can't hit him as easily as you could at the start of the fight. You have to hit him when he's vulnerable. But the thing is, just keep moving. Don't let the stage, try not to get caught on a falling section. And, just wait till Shadow is vulnerable, and then strike. That's basically all there is to it. Once you practice this boss fight a few times, he's not so hard. And, that was a pretty nice move by Shadow right there. He expected me to do a light dash and hit me at just the right time, but watch this. I dodge the Chaos Spear, and I land the killing hit. So that's it for the final battle of Hero Story. Now for the final cutscene.
Sonic! I did it!
Awesome job, Tails!
Sonic!
Look outside!
Woo!
That's awesome.
Don't criticize, I'm just living by my own. Eggman steals the research from a military base located on an island to the south. The military's top secret weapon, Shadow, sealed in the space colony Ark, the seven Chaos Emeralds. When all of the keys have been collected, world conquest will be at hand. Sonic Adventure 2, The Dark Side Story. Long live the Eggman Empire.
All right, so there you have it. That is the hero story for Sonic Adventure 2 Battle. And now that that is finished, we can finally start the Dark Side story. But you'll have to wait until the next episode for that. So this has been Episode 7 of Sonic Adventure 2 Battle Story Mode Playthrough. The hero side story is finished. Stay tuned for the Dark Side story, and if you folks liked what you saw here, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. This is Ultimate Lifeform RB signing out for now. See you folks later!